Virgin Galactic SpaceShip 2 had experienced, and this is sort of the nebulous part. This is what we're working to figure out what this means. This in-flight anomaly, it experienced an in-flight anomaly during a test flight today. This is according to the company. Details on what exactly an in-flight anomaly means in this situation, we don't know yet. We're working to get some more details for you, but we know that Virgin Galactic, we've talked to Richard Branson about this on the show. You know, they have planned for years to sell these trips in which this SpaceShip 2 will take passengers, Richard Branson included, about 62 miles above Earth, the beginning of outer space, and allow them to experience those few minutes of weightlessness and that sense of awe that far out before returning back to ground. Les, what the heck does an in-flight anomaly mean?
Hi, Brooke. We were just discussing that with your producers. It could be almost anything. It could be a computer glitch. It could be some sort of trajectory issue, flight control issue. An anomaly is really a general term for something that normally doesn't happen and can't really be explained. It's not something we normally associate that with computer-based issues on the airplane.
And what more do we know about these different test flights? I mean, this is something I know Richard Branson and his crew has been working on for quite a long time. He's allowed some of our CNN crews out there to see exactly what this will entail. I mean, a lot of excitement surrounding the notion of the SpaceShip 2 taking these passengers going up sort of to the periphery of space. This is something they've been working on for a while.
They have, and it's a lot of innovation, both in aerodynamics and just in the concept alone, to take just the average everyday passenger, up into what qualifies as space. And Burt Rutan, they've been around for a long time with very interesting and innovative aerodynamic designs.